Welcome to Creations Unlimited, another live session. Today I will be showing you how to make craft clay. This is homemade craft clay which we are going to make today. With the help of this, you can make craft items like this. This craft clay work is done using the homemade clay. This is also made using this clay. And in last live session, I had shown you how to make this wall hanging. And that time I had told you that I'll show you how to make the clay at home. So here I am. I will be starting the session soon. So please share the video and invite your friends to join the live session. This is air drying clay. I'll show you how to make the cone also. This is also made with the same recipe. You can store in the airtight container and use it as and when you wish to make a craft. So let's start. So here are the things which you need. Any talcum powder you can take, oil, and Fevicol MR glue. This is Fevicol MR. Don't take the glue which is used for making furniture. This is a craft glue. It is called Fevicol MR. Now I'll adjust the camera and we will start. I store my clay in this airtight container after I make it. And here are the things which I have made using this clay. These are the materials we will be needing. We will need measuring spoons, measuring cup. I told you, talcum powder, oil, and Fevicol MR. So let's begin. Also, some popsicle sticks you need. Take the talcum powder in a little bigger container. I have taken this half a measuring cup. Remove powder in that talcum powder. Take any brand of talcum powder, no problem. Now you need to take glue. As I told you, we are taking this Fevicol MR glue. Take 1 tablespoon of Fevicol MR. This is 1 tablespoon. This measuring spoon is 1 tablespoon. Fill it completely with Fevicol MR. I'll just open the nozzle. I remove the nozzle and pour. So here it is
1 tablespoon of Fevicol MR. Put it in a bowl. I have taken the entire spoon. Now I'm taking 1 teaspoon. It's better to use the proper measuring spoons. And add 4 teaspoons of this talcum powder. Now take 1/4 teaspoon any cooking oil. Let's start mixing it. Take popsicle sticks and mix it. Keep just stirring it. Even if you feel it's a little thick, then also keep mixing it. Don't be in hurry to add glue and all, because you will see that as we keep on mixing, it becomes thin. The clay becomes thin. See, it has started forming a dough. If you will mix more, it's going to become more thin. Don't use spoon. It's better to use popsicle sticks only. Thank you for joining. It's very useful video. Please share it with your friends. Please invite. I have taken a lot of trials for this and have spent long time. So this recipe is really worth following. Keep stirring. Any doubts you have, you can ask me in comments. I will reply to your doubts. Okay, now you can see this has become thin. We will add 1 more teaspoon of powder. Before we had added 4 teaspoons. Now we are adding 1 more. That means it became 5. Again, you can see the clay has become thick. Keep mixing. It's a real-time video, so you will also get the idea exactly how much time it takes. And I'm not mixing any secret ingredients in it. That also you will come to know. Yes, it is craft blue, white blue, correct. As I showed you, I'm taking this Fevicol MR. It's a craft blue by Fevicol company. It is very safe for kids also because we are not mixing any chemicals in it. It's just a talcum powder, cooking oil, and Fevicol MR. Now we had used this spoon for taking oil and just applying it to my hand. Now I'll take this clay and just knead it with my hand also because it becomes perfectly smooth when we mix it with our hands. So in total, as you saw, we have added 5 teaspoon of talcum powder and 1 tablespoon of glue and quarter teaspoon of oil. See how soft it has become? Now it's up to you. You want to make a roll with your hand, you can do it. You want to make petals, you can make it. If you want to make a cone, that I will show you later. Other things I'm showing first. See, this is how it becomes. If you are doing it without cone, then you have to apply glue and then keep these things on that will help it to stick. If you are making cone, then I'll show you how to make a cone. Okay, just apply a little oil to your hand and remove everything from the bowl. Now this you can store it in airtight container like this. You can use it for 6 months also. If your container is airtight, this clay will not dry. But any leakage of, like, if air goes in this container, then of course it will dry because this is air drying clay. Now I'll show you how to make a cone. As you can see, this you can touch easily. It's not sticking to your hand also. See, when I am rolling it on my hand, it's not sticking to my hand. Now for making a cone, we need little thin clay. So let's add quarter teaspoon of white glue in it. As I told you, I am using Fevicol MR and I am going to add quarter teaspoon of glue in it. This is my quarter teaspoon. Okay, let's mix it. Now see, now this clay will not form a ball with your hand. You cannot make a ball of this clay. If you touch it, it will stick to your hand also. It's not forming a ball. I'll add one more. I'll add little more. I'm adding a quarter teaspoon again. Please write it. I will share the recipe in the description. First, I had taken 1 teaspoon, and now I added quarter teaspoon 2 times. That means half teaspoon. Sorry, first I had taken one tablespoon, and now I added half teaspoon glue. Mix it nicely and keep it for 2 minutes. Keep it aside for 2 minutes. By that time, we will make the pour. I'm keeping it here. Now we don't need talcum powder. Here I have taken a plastic bag. Okay, see my plastic bag. The plastic bag should not be very thin. It is this bag. The bag which we have this locking bag, ziplock bag, it is same like that. Yeah. Now I need a square, around 6 inches square. I will be needing. Please share the video so that I can reach to maximum people. Please like it also. When you click like button, I get to reach to many people. My video reaches to many people, I mean. So here I am making a square. I got 2 squares here. We'll need a sellotape. Okay, now take the center of this one side and start rolling. The cone. Before that, let me cut a piece of sellotape. So here I'm taking this side and I'll fold it in this way, like a small triangle. Fold it one more time. We all know how to make a cone. Now you will get an opening here. There you put your finger inside and stick the tape. This is how it will look in the beginning. Now keep rolling this cone. You can tape it one more time. Any doubts you have, you can ask me in comment section. Keep rolling the cone till you finish the square. Now, this is the end part of our plastic sheet. Attach the sellotape there. This way, the cone is ready. Now take any glass and make your cone stand in it in this manner. This is my painting glass. You can take any other thing also. this way also you can make it fit. Anyway, this I am taking. And this is the clay which was ready. Now, before you put any clay here inside, just keep it on any surface and check, is it sticking to the surface? Because we are making a cone, we want to check whether it is sticking to the surface or it is leaving any gap. I think it's visible. You can see it's leaving some gap here. It's not sticking directly to the surface. That means it is still thick. We want to add a little more glue in it. We have to check this before we put the clay in this cone. We have to check this. This is the test. We have to do this. That means it needs a little more glue. I'm going to add 1/4 teaspoon more. Here I'm adding 1/4 teaspoon glue more in it. And we will be mixing. Mix it thoroughly. The first which I showed you, it was how to make clay dough, and now I am showing you how to make clay paste. Because when we are putting it in this cone, we need clay paste. Now let's check it again. Okay, one last 1/4 teaspoon I'm adding. So in total, for the paste, we needed 1 tablespoon of glue plus 1 teaspoon of glue. I will write both the recipes in the description, so don't worry. Or you can note it down while watching the video, you can note it down. Now it's perfect. Now let's add it in the cone. Because once we fill the cone, then we cannot mix the glue later. That is why I checked it 2-3 times before adding it in the cone. So here it has, here I have picked it up with the help of popsicles only, and now I'm adding it, I'm putting it in my cone. We need this cone to stand in a glass container, in any container. I have taken a glass. I am using this Fevicol white glue. It is called as Fevicol MR, which is a craft glue. Yes, I will show you the bottle. Now you will see this glue will slowly, as this is a paste, this glue will slowly go down to the opening of our cone. This is the bottle, blue bottle I have taken. Fevicol MR. It is a craft blue. Now see here, the glue is slowly going down. Let it go down. I want to clean this till then. I want to add this also in it from this container, from this bowl. Okay. Now my container is empty, as you can see. Now I'll press this clay down. Just keep pressing from the top of it. This clay, after making cone, this also you have to store in airtight container, airtight bag, which I showed you before. Both the things you have to store in airtight containers. Now here it's coming towards the opening, as you can see. This you can either put a rubber band or you can seal it with the help of sellotape. I'll put the sellotape. Close it properly. Put the sellotape. One more time. Seal it properly, otherwise when you are pressing the cone from the back side, the clay should come out only from this nozzle, not from the back side. From here it should not come out. So be careful. Now I'll show you how. Okay. Okay, this is how it comes out. From the now, as you saw that how much thickness you want your design, that much we have to cut from the opening, cut for the opening. Here it is now. See the thickness. You can make any design of your choice. Your design should stick to the surface, as I was telling you. See here, there is no gap between the surface and the design. Now suppose if you want to make little fat design, then you have to cut the nozzle little more, cut it extra, so that your design, this is the cut part of that plastic nozzle. So you see the difference now. Now the line has become fat. If you want thicker than this, you can do that also. If you cut more, it becomes more thick. You can write name or any other design with this. See the thickness? It's become fat. Always keep a tissue paper with you. I'm writing Creations Unlimited. You can do it on any surface, cardboard, paper, canvas. Did you find the video useful? Please write in comments. Please share it with your crafty friends. It takes like 1 hour time for it to dry. So here it is, Creations. I was making a bird here. Now I have cut it little big. I have cut the nozzle little big, so bird is not possible with this big nozzle. Anyway, this is how it looks. You can make any design with this. It will stick to the surface because we have already added glue in it. Thank you for joining me for today's live session. I hope you all will make some art and craft using this technique. You can store these clay cones in a plastic airtight container. You can take a plastic box after putting it in this plastic airtight bag. Then again, you keep it in one plastic box, airtight box. So that way your clay will last for many months. So how was the video? Please share it with your friends so that it will help my channel to reach more people. And I will get inspired and motivated to make more such live sessions with you. And subscribing and sharing with your friends is for free. So don't hesitate to do that. So this was here, I'm going to store it. Also, I have this container. In that, I have stored the clay dough. In cone, we have added the clay paste, and here I have kept the cake clay dough. Both the recipes I have shared with you today. So thank you so much for joining me. and hope to see you soon again with another new craft. As I showed you, many things you can make with this plate. This is a nameplate. I'll be showing you how to make a nameplate in another live session. So keep watching Creations Unlimited. Thank you so much for joining. Bye, take care. And don't forget to share.